when lifting a chip, you want to make sure the balls are fully melted. If they are not, you will get an improper lift and probably pull pads. Place it. We are working on a main board which has been previously worked on. It's a xenon board. It was previously reflowed. The GPU was popcorned, unfortunately. So we will now have to clean all the old lead free solder and reball a chip and replace it. There are some bridges over there which causes the GPU to give an error code, 3 rings. Our no video. We have dirt, debris and dust there, old dirty flux. This is not the right flux to use. It gets extremely dark underneath the chip, and as well there is what looks to be like a bit of solder which has escaped from underneath the chip. We will now clean the GPU points on the main board. We're going to use lead solder, which melts at 183°C. To remove the solder that is currently on the board, which is low quality solder, which melts at 217°C. We use the lead solder to melt the lead-free solder, as well as getting lead solder on the pads. This will help using the desoldering braid, as well it will help when seating the replacement chip. We recommend using a sponge with distilled water to clean the tip, so you can tell it's shiny. We will now go over it with some BGA desoldering wick. We do not recommend using goot wick. This is goot wick. As you can tell, the goot wick is a lot thinner and the BGA wick is thicker and has more copper to suck up the solder. You just want a slow and steady motion. You don't really want to pull the braid. You kind of want to glide it over with the iron. I'm simply guiding the braid. You want to avoid going over the chip repeatedly. It's kind of getting stuck because of all the dirt, so we will add some Kingbo Flux to help. Still quite a bit of dirt on the chip, so we will use 99% alcohol. The 99% alcohol does a great job of cleaning the board. Acetone or any other stronger chemicals are not really needed. Since there was quite a bit of dirt on the board, we did not get a baby bottom smooth board. Some of the pads still have solder on them. So we will add some more flux and go over the board again. We are using the same piece of braid. Since it is very thick, it absorbs a lot of solder. We are using a gentle back and forth motion, which is normally not needed. A single swipe will get all the solder. However, since the board was improperly repaired, we have to do additional work, and the cost reflects that. Again, I'm using a gentle motion. I'm barely holding the iron and the braid, merely gliding it over the patch. Make sure to get all the solder off the pads. Again, we will add some 99% alcohol and wipe it away. The sound of the flat board. We have some pre-balled chips, refurbished, which we will place on the board. We will add some Kingbo Flux. You cannot really put too much Kingbo Flux since it's a great flux. However, you can put not enough. Some people prefer to make an entire X with it, but we've found this amount is sufficient. and you simply just want to spread it all over the pads. You want to get all the pads wet so that it will help the solder stick. It also helps to wet the solder balls . It's not necessary, but for people starting out it will help. Then place and align the chip. We no longer need our laser alignment as we've developed a method to get the chip on perfectly. The chip is placed and ready to be heated. We will take the board up to 200 degrees Celsius, not Fahrenheit. The solder actually melts at 183°C, however, we take it up to 200°C to get a solid melting of the balls. The chip will drop in between 180-290°C depending on your thermocouple probe and machine. Thus, we recommend taking it up to 183°C and let it sit for a while, then take it up to 200°C for the final seating of the balls. At that point, the chip will be extremely low to the board and the solder balls will become extremely shiny and silver. At that point, you will shut the machine off and cool the board at a rapid temperature of no more than 3 degrees per sec, and you can then test the board. We are now in the third stage of the profile. You will notice the ball start to drop. As a result, the chip will drop closely to the board, as you can tell. The solder balls start to disappear and the chip drops. We are now approaching 200°C and the profile is going to enter the cooling stage. After the reflow of the reball chip is complete, there are 4 phases to proper profile creation in BGA reworking: preheat, soak, flow, and cool down. We recommend the third phase at 200°C to last for approximately 60-90 seconds. This provides ample cooling. Correction, I mean ample heating of the solder balls to form a solid joint. As you can tell, the chip has now lifted and the balls are visible. We have an Omega thermocouple which slides underneath the chip, as well as an Omega thermocouple which we use to get the board temperature. the temperature difference between the bore temp and actual underchip temp is less than 5 degrees. This is because we are using an IR system, which the board absorbs the IR heat. Provides a more even temp across the board.